So before we begin, a little about myself. Hi, I'm Bonnie. You can find me on the interwebs there. I am a software engineer at Code Academy. So I work in, you know, software at my day job, but I kind of have a bit of a hardware habit. I got started with Arduino in 2013, and then started doing musical programming about a year ago. And I find this stuff really cool and really fun. So I like building electronic musical instruments. When I say that, people usually nod along with me as I say those three words, and then they look at me kind of funny. Because we're used to like two of the phrases in here, but usually not all of them together, right? Everyone has an idea of what electronic music is, right? As a designer, we're all familiar with that. And we all have an idea of what musical instruments are, whether that's something like, you know, a violin or drums or the human voice. We all have an idea of what musical instruments are or should be. But we don't usually see them put together. And part of that is that the way of creating electronic music right now, a lot of people, the way that they perform and interact with it is through interfaces like, you know, buttons and sliders and knobs and all this stuff that's like weirdly unexpressive. And I find that very strange because electronic music, right, like you're literally shaping sound out of nothing. You have this huge, huge range of things that you can produce. And yet we don't usually get the same expressive interface that you get from a normal musical instrument. So I like building electronic musical instruments. I'm going to show you two quick videos of some of mine. I did not go the live demo route because the live demo gods do not always smile upon me. So hopefully you can hear this. This one is called Mother Music. Arduino has been massively successful over the last few years. workshops, we've taken people with zero knowledge and gotten them to like the making sounds of blinking light stage at the end of a couple hours, which is so great. So yeah, Arduino, it's wonderful. And what it does is it's a physical computing platform, so it lets you deal with input and output, right, in the real world. So you have all these sensors. For musical instruments, this is, of course, super important if you want to build an interface. So you've got light, temperature, touch, water, GPS, motion, lots of stuff. And I included this again because, you know, kind of feels like you do can master the four elements. except I guess instead of bringing balance to the world or making music or whatever, minor details. So that's great. And then the second one, and this is one that I think far fewer people will have heard of. Raise your hand if you've heard of Chuck. Oh, great. Yay. That's exciting. So Chuck is a musical programming language. And it was developed at Princeton, and it's designed for use by musicians. And that means that like the primitive things you work with in Chuck are related to things like time and sound. So you can get started making things pretty quickly. It's also free, it's cross-platform, it's not some kind of fancy audio software you're going to need to pay money for. And so, I can show you. So making sound in Chuck is pretty simple. This is Hello World. It'll start. There we go. Yeah, you have to start the virtual machine yourself. That's kind of good. Okay, sorry about that. That was loud. So yeah, like this is all it takes to get started with Chuck, right? You say, I have a sine wave, send it to my speakers, and then wait 1 second. That's all that says. And then if you want to do something like take input, you do something like this. Let me go with 440 unless I go with checks. Yeah, and then I can surround this, right? So we all know, right? Frequency, doubling makes octaves happen. Yay. Okay, so that's like Chuck, very, very briefly. I really like Chuck because the fact that it's so easy to now program sound means that you can just like use whatever parameters you want, right? For programmers, we know how to take things and make them do other things. So how do you combine these? Music and programming and Arduino somehow work together? It's actually more straightforward than you might think. So you take a sensor, in this case a light sensor, that's what it looks like, it costs $1. Plug it into an Arduino board, and now you've got a stream of data, right? So maybe a light sensor gives you values from, say, 0 to 300. It'll change depending on your environment. Okay, great. Now you've got this data. What do you do with it? Well, you can literally, if you want to be lazy like me, just take a USB cable and plug your Arduino into your computer and send it over serial. And it turns out that that's really, really straightforward and easy and cheap. Mm-hmm. I like the combination of these things. And then you can just process the data in Chuck, right? And again, that means that you can just make it do whatever you want. I'm obviously hand-waving a lot of stuff away here. If you want to try making this stuff and seeing what actually goes into it under the hood and want to get confirmed for yourself that I'm not like telling lies, these are three of my projects, including the first two, the ones that I showed up on YouTube. I also, Bang Bang Hun, retweeted the slide deck so you can get them later. And I have all the code, I have all the circuit diagrams, you can build them yourself. Piano stairs are something I didn't show off, but they're a good beginner project, so you can make things. And I'm gonna end on this great theme. Anything is possible if you just use your imagination. Because the cool thing about combining these ingredients is that it's kind of true. So like a light sensor, right? So for my Lua phone, the one where I was going like this, you can use it to control volume and vibrato. You can also use it as, say, a light-based tripwire. I did that for piano stairs. So you put one horizontally on a step, and there's a shadow that makes someone's foot there, so you make a piano key sound. You can also like imitate the Apple Watch and like stick one on a wristband, right, and get a really like performance pulse sensor, and then